This is Tyler. Tyler, with Grammarly's help, is writing an email to his boss, Anita. Tyler sits just 15 feet away, though it can feel like the distance.
Today I'm going to be giving a brief tutorial on how I put spikes into my wigs. First things first, before we jump into the actual how-to, I want to touch on a couple things. To start, the type of wig you use will affect the end result. The thinner your wig is, the less full your spikes will be. The type of top on your wig will also affect the result. If it has a large skin top, you may have to fight the hair more to get it to go in the direction you want it to. However, that being said, you can still make some pretty crazy hairstyles happen regardless of what wig you choose to use. So to prove this, I'm using a cheap $15 wig I bought back in 2011 for this tutorial. To begin spiking, I like to take my teasing brush and begin back combing. You can use a fine tooth comb as well, but I highly recommend a teasing brush if you plan to do this a lot. It will cut your time in half, if not more. Next, I begin smoothing the outside of my spike with a fine tooth comb. You want to leave the inside gnarled up so it has some stability, but you want the outside to look clean. When you're done with smoothing, it's time to hairspray. Hold your hairspray about 8 to 10 inches. Cut your time in half, regardless of what wig you choose to use. So to prove this, I'm using a cheap $15 wig I bought back in 2011 for this tutorial. To begin spiking, I like to take my teasing brush and begin back combing. You can use a fine tooth comb as well, but I highly recommend a teasing brush if you plan to do this a lot. It will cut your time in half, if not more. Next, I begin smoothing the outside of my spike with a fine tooth comb. You want to leave the inside gnarled up so it has some stability, but you want the outside to look clean. When you're done with smoothing, it's time to hairspray. Hold your hairspray about 8 to 10 inches away and lightly spray the base of your spike while holding it in the shape and direction you want. Then you're going to take your hair dryer on low heat while still holding it and dry your spray into place. This will set your spike and make it so that it stands straight up. Next, you're going to trim off the extra hair at the top by cutting downwards into your spike. This thins out the top so it's easier to bring your hair together and get it super pointy. Once you've trimmed it to your desired length, spray a light amount of hairspray at the top of the spike, pinch it together, and use your hairdryer to set it. Then last but not least, if you want to make sure your spikes stay more securely, you can use spiking glue or, as I like to use, clear tacky glue to seal the tips. All you're going to do is simply twist the top of the spike between your fingers and you're done. Trim any stray hairs at the top and you're ready to go. Thanks for watching, and I hope this helps you with your own wig styling adventures. Make some pretty crazy hairstyles happen regardless of what wig you brush and begin back combing. You can use a fine tooth comb as well, but
First things first. To get a spike, you want to how to go about doing this, but I'll give it a go.
Yeah, this is where it starts to get emotional. All that purple looks so beautiful.
guys are beautiful. Can we come back?
Check out what that video said after to do after straightening. So first,
highly recommend a teasing brush if you plan to do this a lot. It will cut your time in half, if not more. Next, I begin smoothing the outside of my spike with a fine tooth comb. You want to leave the inside gnarled up so it has some stability, but you want the outside to look clean.
Okay. To the inside, it needs to be a bit curled up as well. Never meant to go. Then what did she do after that?
When you're done with smoothing, it's time to hairspray. Hold your hairspray about 8 to 10 inches away and lightly spray the base of your spike while holding it in the shape and direction you want. Then you're going to take your hair dryer on low heat while still holding it and dry your
hair. Dryer. Oh, I need a hair dryer.
sound like? Y'all sound like drunken angels. Sing! Thank you guys for helping us honor.
Use happy.
Set your spike and make it so that it stands straight up. When you're done with smoothing, it's time to hairspray. Hold your hairspray about 8 to 10 inches away and lightly spray the base of your spike while holding it in the shape and direction you want. Then you're going to take your hair dryer on low heat while still holding it and dry your spray into place. This will set your spike and make it so that it stands straight up. Next, you're going to trim off the extra hair at the top by cutting downwards into your spike. This thins out the top so it's easier to bring your hair together and get it super pointy. Once you've trimmed it to your desired length, spray a light amount of hairspray at the top of the spike, pinch it together, and use your hairdryer to set it. Then last but not least, if you want to make sure your spikes stay more securely, you can use spiking glue.
Okay.
I like to take my teasing brush and begin back combing. You can use a fine tooth comb as well, but I highly recommend a teasing brush if you plan to do this a lot. It will cut your time in half, if not more. Next, I begin smoothing the outside of my spike with a fine tooth comb. You want to leave the inside gnarled up so it has some stability, but you want the outside to look clean. When you're done with smoothing, it's time to hairspray. Hold your hairspray about 8 to 10 inches away and lightly spray the base of your spike while holding it in the shape and direction you want. Then you're going to take your hair dryer on low heat while still holding it and dry your spray into place. This We'll set your spike and make it so that it stands straight up. Next, you're going to trim off the extra hair at the top by cutting downwards into your spike. This thins out the top so it's easier to bring your hair together and get it super pointy. Once you've trimmed it to your desired length, spray a light amount of hairspray at the top of the spike, pinch it together, and use your hairdryer to set it. Then last but not least, if you want to make sure your spikes stay more securely, you can use spiking glue, or as I like to use, clear tacky glue to seal the tips. All you're going to do is simply twist the top of the spike between your fingers and you're done. Trim any stray hairs at the top and you're ready to go. Thanks for watching, and I hope this helps you with your own wig styling adventures.
Okay. That's one little spike.
Yeah, this is where it starts to get
a fine tooth comb as well, but I highly recommend a teasing brush if you plan to do this a lot. It will cut your time in half, if not more.
Man.
Next, I begin smoothing the outside of my spike with a fine tooth comb. Yeah. You want to leave the inside gnarled up so it has some stability, but you want the outside to look clean. When you're done with smoothing, it's time to hairspray. Hold your hairspray about 8 to 10 inches away and lightly spray the base of your spike while holding it in the shape and direction you want. Then you're going to take your hairdryer on low heat while still holding it and dry your spray into place. This will set your spike and make it so that it stands straight up.
She holds it in a spike. That's it. That way. Let's have a look at Mia's picture. Quite thin spikes, doesn't it? I don't know. Get this picture up.
You guys are beautiful.
He does have quite thin spikes in his hair.
Can we come back?
Check the video again.
Smoothing, it's time to hairspray. Hold your hairspray about 8 to 10 inches away and lightly spray the base of your spike while holding it in the shape and direction you want. Then you're going to take your hairdryer on low heat while still holding it and dry your spray into place. This will set your spike and make it so that it stands straight up. Next, you're going to trim off the extra hair at the top by cutting downwards into your spike. This thins out the top so it's easier to bring your hair together and get it super pointy.
I'm gonna steal it from my hand.
quite a lot of spikes, doesn't he? He has a lot of spikes. A lot of spikes. A lot of individual totally up, all his head up, with nothing hanging down.
You know what they kind of sound like? They all sound like drunken angels. Sing! Thank you guys for helping us honor.
Is this like that or not? I'm not sure. Now, does she spray the top as well?
Once you've trimmed it to your desired length, done with smoothing, it's time to hairspray. Hold your hairspray about 8 to 10 inches away and lightly spray the base of your spike while holding it in the shape and direction you want. Then you're going to take your hair dryer on low heat while still holding it and dry your spray into place. This will set your spike and make it so that it stands straight up. Next, you're going to trim off the extra hair at the top by cutting downwards into your spike. This thins out the top so it's easier to bring your hair together and get it super pointy. Once you've trimmed it to your desired length, spray a light amount of hairspray at the top of the spike, pinch it together, and use your hairdryer to set it. Then last but not least, if you want to make sure your spikes stay more securely, you can use spiking glue or, as I like to use, clear tacky glue to seal the tip. All you're going to do is simply twist the top of the spike between your fingers and you're done. Trim any stray hairs at the top and you're ready to go. Thanks for watching the top by cutting downwards into your spike. This thins out the top so it's easier to bring your hair together and get it super pointy. Once you've trimmed it to your desired length, spray a light amount of hairspray at the top of the spike.
Yeah.
make it so that it stands straight up. Next, you're going to trim off the extra hair at the top by cutting downwards into your spike. This thins out the top so it's easier to bring your hair together and get it super pointy. Once you've trimmed it to your desired length, spray a light amount of hairspray at the top of the spike, pinch it together, and use your hair dryer to set it. Then last but not
least, top.
To bring your hair together and get it super pointy. Once you've trimmed it to your desired length, spray a light amount of hairspray at the top of the spike, pinch it together, and use your hair dryer to set it.
Pinch it together while hairspraying. Okay. Sorry? Alright. Spike, my first ever spike, is not too bad. I think, well. Not too bad. He has quite a few spikes on his hair. Right. Let me look at his picture again. Yeah, he has quite a lot of thin spikes. I don't know. Maybe I've made this one too thick. I don't know. How do these spikes go on top of his head? I think they just go straight up, right? Just go straight up, pretty much. Literally, that there's nothing hanging down. Okay. Okay. But there's a lot of small spikes. Small spikes in his hair, which so, I don't know, maybe it's too thick, I don't know. Maybe it was.
It's been 7 hours and 13 days.
Set your spike and make it so that it stands straight up. Next, you're going to trim off the extra hair at the top by cutting downwards into your spike. This thins out the top so it's easier to bring your hair together and get it to choose to use. So to prove this, I'm using a cheap $15 wig I bought back in 2011 for this tutorial. To begin spiking, I like to take my teasing brush and begin back combing. You can use a fine tooth comb as well, but I highly recommend a teasing brush if you plan to do this a lot. It will cut your time in half, if not more. Next, I begin smoothing the outside of my spike with a fine-tooth comb. You want to leave the inside gnarled up so it has some stability, but you want the outside to look clean. When you're done with smoothing, it's time to hairspray. Hold your hairspray about 8 to 10 inches away and lightly spray the base of your spike while holding it in the shape and direction you want. Then you're going to take your hair dryer on low heat while still holding it and dry your spray into place. This will set your spike and make it so that it stands straight up. Next, you're going to trim off the extra hair at the top by cutting downwards into your spike. so it's easier to bring your hair together and get it super pointy. Once you've trimmed it to your desired length, spray a light amount of hairspray at the top of the spike, pinch it together, and use your hair dryer to set it. Then last but not least, if you want to make sure your spikes stay more securely, you can use spiking glue, or as I like to use, clear tacky glue to seal the tips. All you're going to do is simply twist the top of the spike between your fingers and you're done. Trim any stray hairs at the top and you're ready to go. Thanks for watching, and I hope this helps you with your own wig styling adventures.
So this is a thinner one, so if I can get thinner ones, and which Rhea has, he has quite a few thin spikes. I think this one may be a bit too thick, to be honest. But anyway, I can maybe separate that one later, I don't know. Right. But the lower part is at least stable. That spike. Right, now after that is the top one, top part of the spike, I think. Let me have a look.
The outside of my spike with a fine tooth comb. You want to leave the inside gnarled up so it has some stability, but you want the outside to look clean. When you're done with smoothing, it's time to hairspray. Hold your hairspray about 8 to 10 inches away and lightly spray the base of your spike while holding it in the shape and direction you want. Then you're going to take your hair dryer on low heat while still holding it and dry your spray into place. This will set your spike and make it so that it stands straight up. Next, you're going to trim off the extra hair.
Trim up the top. Okay. In the top part. It still works with the thin amount of hair, so that's very good. Alright, let's trim the top part. Tricking. know if it's, this is just thinning it out, so it makes it easier to make a point. That's better. Right. Spray the top part. There we go. Right, spray the top part. She sprayed the top part, right? I think she sprayed the top
hair
part.
At the top, by cutting downwards into your spike. This thins out the top so it's easier to bring your hair together and get it super pointy.
Right.
Once you've trimmed it to your desired length, spray a light amount of hairspray at the top of the spike, pinch it together, and use your hairdryer to set it.
Okay. Spray the top of the spike. There we go. And I'll bring it together. Not bad. He has sort of curled spikes though, doesn't he? No, they are spikes. They're just thin spikes. Yeah, pretty much. They're thin spikes. And then the hair dryer treatment. Maybe a bit more hairspray on the lower part. Good. Not bad. He has tons of spikes. Yeah, he's got spiky hair. Right. They're really all over the place, huh? But they're all sort of swept back. Sure, this one's too thick at the back, but should be alright. move on to the next one, I think. Certainly going not too badly so far. Alright, well, we'll see. Just take some other pictures of Rio's hair. Rio, Hazuki. It here? I guess I can just do a thin one here, I don't know, or right in front.
Yeah, this is where it starts to get emotional. All that purple looks so beautiful.
Yeah, maybe here, right in front, I don't know. I can put another one. Here. Thank you.
eyes are beautiful. Can we come back?
Right, hairspray. That purple rain.
Sounds is action.
Good. way to talk.
Sound like drunken angels. Sing.
Yeah, not bad.
Thank you guys for helping us honor.
Not bad. I feel it's how it's going to turn out, but I'll give it my best shot. His spikes are all over the place, man. They are just spiking up everywhere. So perhaps I shouldn't just do it in a row. I should just do it everywhere. Thin spike, because he has a lot of thin spikes. I don't know if they'll stay up. working that air. Hey, alright, hell yeah. This is the I'm trying to do. This is a Shenmue stream, but not as you know it, boy. Not as you know it. I'm trying to get his wig styled, and it's also my first ever time I'm doing the styling of the wig. So, I'm gonna give it a shot, and I'll give it a shot. But it's gonna be difficult. He's got lots of thin spikes. I'm trying. Right. Yeah, he has a lot of them. And very close together. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, but I've got a thin one. I've got my first thin one done here, so maybe not going too badly. So at least I'm getting the spikes up. And he also has them on the back. I just noticed. He never noticed it much from the game angles. But yeah, that's right. A lot of different spikes. It's like he sort of just like brushed it all back or something with spikes, or he's just put his fingers up and gone like that through his hair, right? And like he stayed in that position. After that, he flattened that. I watched the video and he cleaned it out. He cleaned it out at the top. And then he didn't really flatten it out, but I'm going to flat it out just to try and get the spike in that way. So this is what you get to at midnight. No man, this is my first ever time I've done it, Timmy. This is the first time, boy. So this is new territory for me. I'm gonna try and get his hair right. Oh, by the way, there's a Sega Mega Drive Mini launch party tomorrow in London. So I was thinking of maybe cosplaying this if I can do it. If I can get his hair. His hair is like the most almost like one of the most important parts, right? So if I can get it done, maybe I might cosplay it tomorrow. It's wear hair, it's not really a Dragon Ball hair, it's more realistic, even for 99. If you look at it, it's pretty realistic. I know people with hair like that. I used to use it a bit like that years ago, but now I keep it down. What about the gaming event in a few weeks at Excel? Yeah. So if I can get it done, then I might do it for EGX, right? EGX, Eurogamer, isn't it? It's Eurogamer. But he's got a lot of different spikes, right? So let's get down to it. Thinned it out on top, then hairspray at the top, yeah, then twist it together to make a spike, while putting Oh, it's working. I got it right. That's the level of thinness he has right here on this front one I've just done. So if I can keep getting them like that, then it could be alright. Yeah, what? Are you going to it? Yeah, totally could promote some sales for Shenmue 3 at EGX. He has a pretty casual cosplay though, isn't it? So, I don't know. I'm not sure, right? Could it? Hey, Unicorn. Thank you for the 1,000. So, I don't know. Maybe it could promote some sales. I don't know, man. That would be funny if it did. So, what kind of game is this? I said, yeah, it's an amazing game. yeah, you've been playing through it, right? I saw you, it's your first playthrough. You've been playing through it on... I watched some of your first playthrough. Do it on one of the days. Yeah, I think this is the most tricky part of his cosplay, because it's that thing that I need to spend some time on it. I mean, the rest of it is what? His jacket, trainers, jeans, and a plaster there. Can't forget the plaster, man. We'll get that Shenmue plaster there, straight from the one they gave away at Tokyo Game Show. As it stands, might go along to it on one of the, oh yeah, nice. Well, that is good that I've managed to get a spike that is that thin. I was kind of worried that I couldn't get the spike to stand up if it's that thin. Like there. People joke before about Ryu, if you take that plaster off and you see inside Ryu and he's a robot. How are you finding the game, by the way, dude? By the way, Timmy versus first playthrough of Shenmue 1, Hell was here. I think it's your first playthrough, right? Ryu can run without stopping for a breath. It's been decent. Sucks to wait for things. and it's a speeded up day as well, Timmy, in the game. Could you imagine if it was real time? You'd be playing like a real life simulator, boy. Give it some time, isn't it? Which part are you up to? Darts still not that great generally, but did get like near 400 score. Oh, that's pretty good. Did you go to the arcade? Right. Now I've got to flatten out the top. It flatten out the top, then some hairspray. Then twist it into a spike. Yeah, there you go. There's tons of. So let's. That's it. Yep, been hanging at the arcade when have to wait. So, which part are you up to? Have you been collecting the capsule toys as well? And the cassette tapes, that's it. Oh shit. I'm just after when you are looking in the room for the Phoenix mirror. Oh, nice, nice. I like that bit, man. That's awesome. When you can light your surroundings. Yeah, I like. That's really cool, man. That's awesome. That is so cool, man. Remember playing that game for the first time? It was just amazing, man. One thing it's really good at is the immersion. Shenmue is really great at that, I think. The warehouse I got mixed up, as Rinny460 was saying about when he should be at it, and the time I was at it was wrong. Okay. That's the thing about Shenmue. This is kind of like certain events will trigger at certain times, isn't it? And it's sometimes the timing is quite tight as well, and you have to do certain things. brother. Yeah. He's, let's see, his hair should be pushed back further. It's not at the back. It's sort of all standing up, isn't it? At the front. That's better. It should be like that. That's looking a bit better. It should be. That's it. Have you had to fight Chai yet? That's better. Because his hairline sort of goes like that. It's literally right at the top of where his roots are. Oh, nice. That creepy SOB is coming for you, boy. Get your training on. Get practice them moves, boy. Yeah. He's tough as well, so you need to get practicing, man. Did Vinny tell you about him? Did the Vinmeister? Right. He did compare Australia's authority on Shenmue, Vinny 460. Oh shit. it starts signing this wig, it's gonna put my cosplay skills to the test, that's for sure. My cosplay crafting skills to the test. How you liking your new girlfriend, man? How you liking Nozomi? She's your babe now, Timmy. Put her true feelings forward. So she's your babe now. She's your babe. Oh, that's good. Oh, should stand up. Huh? Yeah, she always worries about you. I would have played the HD editions of Shenmue 1 and 2 sooner if did not have problems with running Windows on my Mac. Oh. Yeah, you run Windows on your Mac? Oh, really? I didn't know you ran Windows on your Mac. Oh, okay. So you have a Mac, you don't have a PC, right? Yeah, I guess I've never tried anything like that. So you got it running okay now? Ouch. Right, thin out the top. There's a lot to do here, so I just sort of try and do it slowly by slowly. I think this wig is quite intense, man. Yeah, you can use wig. Well, I bought the HD editions on PS4. All right, instead, bought the HD editions on PS4. Because I didn't know what to do to make the Windows run properly on Mac after it was having problems. Okay. So, are you still running it? Wait, what are you doing your playthrough on then? Is it PS4, yeah? Oh, okay, okay. Well, yeah, that's the one of the great appeals of consoles. Just their ease of use, right? You just, you know, that's one of the definitely one of the pro points of consoles, I think. You know, just you got the disc, put it in, and then it works. Great, that's it. Don't have to worry about this and that. So I've got that bit sorted. Now the top part of the spike. Right. Flatten that out. Get it out a bit. Rather not have to worry over what's wrong. Exactly. Exactly. I mean, that's kind of what's annoying sometimes about PC. Sometimes, like, there's something wrong which you don't know. You have to fiddle about with the settings. You have to go into the hard drive or solid state drive. You know, mess about with it, and you just, oh, I just want to play the game. Okay. All right, top half this way. That's not bad, man. If I can, you know, this is not bad. I mean, if I can get these thin spikes all the time, then maybe I can get it started like Riyadh. But that no looking like it as time has it. Rather than not, really the best deal would have been Shenmue 1 to on Switch. Oh, yeah. I hope, you know, oh, yes. Vinny, did you see the... I saw the video on YouTube. Someone put a good video there where about the Nintendo Switch. What the likelihood? You know, they're basically saying Nintendo are going to use the Sharp's Exo screen, like especially like a high end screen in their the next model of the Nintendo Switch to be released, probably sometime next year. So I'm definitely going to get that. That's for sure. Definitely interested with that one. So maybe we'll eventually get a port. I don't know. It's not completely off the table. Because I think they want to release their, you know, there's something to compete with the Xbox Project Scarlet and PS5, probably, isn't it? So, this music is just awesome. Yeah, the triple replay of the soccer ball into a goon. The soccer ball into a goon. Oh, is that where he kicks it? I forgot now. That's right. Oh, yeah, yeah, for the boy, yes. Oh, yes, 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 yeah, I remember, yeah, yeah. When you rescue the bull from the gang. Yeah, yeah. That's awesome. Oh man, you're playing it just at the right time as well, man. Just before Shenmue 3 comes out. Awesome, man. Some more at the base. Not that never not seen what number one is like, but yeah. Did not get to play properly. Yeah, so yeah, I think there's a lot of people, you know, and a lot of people potentially like you, isn't it, that haven't seen the greatness of Shenmue, man, really. But it's just so awesome that the game's getting another chance, you know. It's getting another chance, and then it's not forgotten. Because it so could have easily been. But for the passion of the fans, basically, that has bring it back, which I hardly can think of any other game that there's an equivalent to, really. Probably would have been extremely costly for people to buy Shenmue 1 on Dreamcast had it not been for the HD edition. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, exactly. That's right. So, yeah, even the HD edition is... Well, I think the fans are responsible for that because the fans were... Over the years, they kept asking Sega to re-release it in HD. Like they was holding like tweet-a-thons every week or something, just tweeting at Sega, release Shenmue 1 and 2 HD before Shenmue 3 comes out. Which they did it for ages, and Sega then finally done it. Man. So the fact that has happened is just awesome. So like, you know. It's given Shenmue 3 a better chance, you know. is right. This is looking better. It's looking better, man. Hopefully that HD edition can come to the Switch and Xbox. I mean, the Switch, you know, and then Shenmue 3 can come to the Xbox as well. And I don't know, what about Switch? If there's a new, more powerful one coming out, then why not, man? That'd be brilliant. That spiked. Nice. Everything Sega ported to Switch. Yeah, they've been supporting the Switch, right? They have been supporting the Switch. Got something at least on it for now. Yeah, yeah. They have been supporting the Switch well, so. That can only be a good thing. There we go. It's taking shape. Yeah, I mean, they got quite a few games on Virtual Console. I know, like some of the older Sega titles. Virtual Racing is one I really want to get when I get my Switch. Keep going. Let's do another one here. Just remembered that Super Monkey Ball Banana Blitz HD folks. Yeah, Super Monkey Ball's a fun game. Have you ever played one? A Super Monkey Ball? I've got it, I think originally it was on GameCube, Xbox, and PS2. It's a fun game, if you've never played it. You don't actually control the monkey ball. You control the environment around it. So it's like a sort of like a puzzle game. Yeah, it's a puzzle game. You played it, yeah? I think that soon. The two on the GameCube, yes. All right, yeah. Number one and two, and then they released the deluxe version. I remember when I think reading interviews about Super Monkey Ball. It was when a time when Sega didn't have much money, and they was thinking about how to create a game with as small budget as possible, but to still be innovative in their approach. And I think Super Monkey Ball was pretty much what they came out with, isn't it? Toshihiro Nagoshi, who's still at Sega, man. He's basically the main guy behind Yakuza. Anyways, shall be off. Have fun crafting this bike. Yeah, see ya. See you in a bit, Timmy. Have a good night, buddy. Thanks for stopping by, my friend. Coming together though, it's looking better and better. I don't know how it's gonna turn out, but it's looking better and better. Hello, hello. Good evening, sir. How are you doing? How are you doing? Well, thank you. Being very generous there. Aren't you a generous little Mr. B? How do you like what I've done so far, man? It's coming together. It's my first time doing it, but it's going all right. Let's see. All right. Now this one I haven't finished yet. Oh, you had a long day. You got a bit of burnout there. Finally home and eating dinner. Wow. Was it one of those days for Mr. Brightside 417? So just one of those days, huh? Right, trim the top of the spike, get it a bit thinner. What are you having for dinner, man? You're having, you need an energy boost, man. That's what you need, man. Need an energy boost, boy. Looks like a lot of work. What, this? I think there is, because if you look at his hair, he's got loads of tiny little spikes. So yeah, man, this is the first time I've done it as well. So it's uncharted territory for me. But I'm giving it a go, man. See? Italian food for an Italian American person. Right. Twist the spike together. It's all right, man, that's gonna give you some energy for all that gaming you're gonna do, boy. Well, what's easiest and quickest things to make? You need the energy, man, to keep your gaming, the game on top of your game, man. Oh shit. Oh man. Oh, I can get a spike here. That should be good. I might do more Battlefront tonight. Ooh. How did you think PUBG went the other day, man? That was pretty good, man, wasn't it? You got yourself a bit of improvement, didn't it? You killed some dudes, man. Are you sure? Can I get a spike here? Yeah, I think I can, man. Yeah, man, I'm down for that. I'm down for getting our first win, man. We haven't won one yet. We got second. Is the thingy gonna join us? Is Mr. Full-Time Streamer gonna join us? FFG Gaming. I think I need to push this back, man, further. Yeah, it needs to go further back. Like that. Thank you. Is it gone part time already? Yeah, it didn't last too long, right? Certainly would take advantage of that time. Oh, yeah. Well, I thought it would be, huh? I don't know. Maybe he's gone part time already, man. I don't know. Right, there's definitely one here. You'll play games for next week. I'm off all week. All right. I think I'm going to save my single player games for next week. I'm off work all week. Oh yeah, what's that? Which games is going? Which one? Is that Resident Evil? Control, out and work on Cobain and Green Reaper. Oh yes. I saw some reviews of Cobain, man. It looks quite interesting. Do you like it? Is Code Vein any good? Okay. Because I've played Bandai Namco's Tales series. I was wondering if it was going to be like that, but from the reviews it said it's like Dark Souls, but with an anime look, right? Staying up? Ooh, it is staying up. I think I'm going to have to like push it all back when I've got most of the spikes done, because his hair sort of gets curled back at the top, kind of like it's being hit by the wind. Yeah, I can't stream too late tonight either. My boss wants me in early. Okay. See. So you're gonna get on. You usually get on in about half an hour, don't you? About. Yeah, well, once you get your PC, man, you must be looking forward to that, man. It's gonna take you, it's gonna level you up, boy. And also eliminate some of those problems you have been having with your Xbox. About the hairline, but anyway, just gonna seriously look at them next week when I'm off and plan a pitch. Yeah. I mean, you can get, you should be able to get one that does everything that you want in it for around $600 something, right? Yeah, exactly, man. You must be looking forward to not having all those technical issues, man. Like having to stream without a camera and gears and everything like that, man. And you can customize it as well and shit. Use bots and stuff. Yeah. surprised just how good this hairspray is, man. It's strong. Staying up. Whew. Yeah, you get through a lot of different games, don't you, man? You play a new one like almost every week or something like that, isn't it, man? So much so that you don't always finish the other games, isn't it? Yeah, that's right, isn't it? Especially around this the holiday period, isn't it? That's for sure.
Easy.
Hey, thank you for the for what you sent me. Do you like the little animation? The top of the spike. And twist it into a spike. Alright, see you in a bit. See you in a bit, buddy. Thanks for stopping by. Cheers, dude. certainly looking better. I gotta say, that is looking better. It's looking more like spikes. It is spikes. Push this part back. That looks better, so it's more fuller, the spikes are fuller. Okay. Right, I'm gonna call it a night there. One more. That looks kind of better, actually, once I've separated the spikes a little bit. That certainly looks a bit better, because he isn't big spikes. He's got lots of little spikes. Right, I'm gonna end for tonight, but thank you for all who's joined, and I'll catch you all later.